guys, and welcome to Women World Changers episode 2.
I'm Nikki Soohoo.
And I'm Rachele Brooke Smith.
And today we are featuring one of our favorite actresses, Emma Watson.
Saw Beauty and the Beast, and hands down, like, one of my favorite movies. I literally did start crying.
And you also know her from Harry Potter and Perks of Being a Wallflower.
All incredible films, incredible performances by such a young badass.
Yeah. Amazing. But something that you may not know about her is she was actually named the number one, like, grossing actress of the decade back when she was doing, like, the Harry Potter
wow.
stuff.
Wow. You know, I did
and
not know
I think
that
she
about.
Was, like, 15 or 17, or, like,
crazy.
She was still under age. Yes. Like, she was still a kid, and she was making the most money as a woman.
Another thing about how age is just a number, and right? there are no limitations. It's just you.
Yes.
You know, you are your limitation.
And another cool fact is she was also the youngest to be featured on the cover of Teen Vogue.
That's amazing. Mm-hmm. And that's one of the reasons why we're featuring her, is because she didn't let that age or limitation get in her way. She broke that, and not only that, she's making such a big impact on the world. She's using her platform for so much good.
Yes, she is super, super educated. She went to an Ivy League school, Brown University, but she's also known to be a feminist.
Yeah, another fun fact that you may not know about her is that, you know, she is a quote-unquote feminist, and not to have that word has some kind of weird stereotypes to
yeah
it,
some people think that yes. there's, you know, a negative connotation in that feminism means man-hating or something
yeah.
like that, but she actually said that in her UN speech.
Yep. When she spoke at the United Nations, that's what she talked about.
Exactly. That's not what feminism is.
Yep.
That feminism is just giving women a choice on how they want to live their lives.
So awesome, and, like, so eye-opening, and so I love that she literally is, you know, for lack of better terms, disrupting that belief,
totally.
You know, that certain people have. And I think that is what is a world changer. You know, when
yes.
you stand up for something you believe in, regardless of whatever anybody else might think. Like, she could have been, she probably did get some, like, haters about that.
No, actually, like, people were telling her before she did her speech that she shouldn't use the word feminism because of the negative connotations. And she said she thought about it for a long time, and she just actually decided, no, it's the right thing to do, and I'll explain myself about it. Even.
And I think that's such a great point just for all of us to recognize that anybody that has ever made massive impact in this world had that same choice and made a similar decision that, regardless of what anybody else thought about it, they knew and felt it was right, and they went for it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and I bet if you asked her, she was probably scared, probably insecure
totally.
About it. Probably.
And she did get a lot of haters
yes.
afterwards.
But she also made a massive impact and inspired and probably helped so, like, countless people because of that.
She actually said after, you know, because right after her speech, she started getting hate mail, like, right away.
Wow.
And threats on, you know, who
yeah.
she was and how they were gonna expose her and, you know, call her out for claiming to be one thing and then doing something controversial against it. And she said, you know, that's exactly why I'm doing this, is
yes.
because, like, these people, you know, like
yeah.
I need to be doing this. It fueled her, and it just gave her more motivation to keep fighting for what she believes in.
Another great point that I love that you said, like, it fueled her. You know, when you make a decision like that, like a solid decision that you're gonna take action, regardless of any fear or doubt, worry, insecurity, that when you make a solid decision and you move forward in it, that builds so much confidence and strength and trust in self, which is so important.
That's what you have to do, is you
yep.
have to take that energy, take that negative energy, and let it actually fuel you into
yep.
positive action.
Mm-hmm. Our job to transform it into whatever
totally
we need it to be to fuel our lives.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a big
yeah.
life lesson that,
like,
changed my life.
Just to break that down
yeah.
for ourselves in
yeah.
our own lives. Like, let's say you're in school
yeah.
or you're at work, and there are just people that are bringing a negative energy
mm-hmm.
into your being.
Yep.
You have to realize that has nothing to do with you.
Nope.
That they are just reflecting what's happening inside of them.
Mm-hmm.
And so don't take it personally.
It's a constant practice too,
mm-hmm.
you know? And every audition that we go on, or any, like, quote unquote rejection that you get, or someone makes fun of you,
mm-hmm.
you know, it's realizing that it's not about you.
Right.
You know, what the only thing you can control is what you're giving out.
Totally.
So if you're focused on giving awesome energy out, like spreading kindness, spreading love, adventuring, living your passion, your life, that you'll start to see those things just not bother you so much anymore. And it's a practice, right? Because sometimes it's really hard.
Yeah.
If you hear different things people saying about you or bad things happen that you didn't expect or want, you know, that is such a focus and a practice.
So what are some tools that you do when you feel like people are being negative towards you? How do you turn yourself around?
Well, one, I think it's a commitment to really being cautious about who you're spending your time with. Like,
totally.
I choose to spend my time with people like Nikki here because she's super inspiring. I know that when I'm around her, she's gonna lift me up. And one of the biggest things to think about is that if you never let go of the old, there's no room to bring in new.
Yeah, you end up closing yourself off to the new opportunities that are out there.
Yep.
So another great tool that we use often is kind of this form of meditating and resetting ourselves. Yep. And asking ourselves, especially in a very like quick situation,
yes,
we usually say, okay, just focus on what are you grateful for.
Yep.
So when anything kind of bad or stressful happens to us, we just try and refocus our attention on something that we are grateful for and something that makes us happy. And it helps kind of bring us back onto a high flying disc.
Yeah, no, and you know, just like why we're putting this stuff out here is what you focus on expands. Like, we want to focus on all the awesome stuff that people are doing out there, so we see more of that. You know, and what you're focused on in your life, in your head, if you're focused on, oh, why don't they like me? Why are they saying these bad things about me? My life sucks, it's so awful. You're just gonna get more of that.
Exactly.
So as soon as you can say, whoa, I don't want that. Like, what do I want? You know, and how can I get there? You know, what am I so grateful for now that I can focus on? Because gratitude is like, when you can get real gratitude, where you actually feel it.
You won't feel fear, you won't feel anger, you won't feel hate, or anything negative. You'll just feel good.
I mean, I love to say that gratitude is the new sexy, because I think the people that are grateful, if you watch people that are just so grateful for everything they have, it's magnetic. You know, you want to be around that kind of energy because it makes you feel good.
So another thing that you were actually just touching on was manifesting, or just honestly putting out there what it is that you want to be, even if you're not that. So sometimes we do it like, you know, you'll say, I am this. I am confident, I am strong, and I am happy right now.
It's a whole different feeling in your body.
Yeah.
And even, you know, for myself, a big challenge I've always had is time management. Like, I'm pretty much, it's a big challenge for me. So, but I used to always say, like, I would claim it for myself and say, yeah, I'm usually late, or I'm always late, or I have a hard time being on time.
And then she would continue to do that.
Be that.
Yeah.
But as soon as I start, and I've been challenging myself to say, every time I felt myself or even hear somebody say that, I'm like, no, I'm awesome at being on time. Like, I'm always early. And even if I don't believe it at first, like, the more that I say that and claim that, the more that
she
my
gets
mind
better
will focus
at it,
on it.
At least.
I think there's a big difference between, there are some things in life that you make a solid, like, super hardcore decision that you really can change in a second, and that all comes from, like, your why. Like, I'm sure that Emma Watson, before she was gonna give that speech, you know, with, I think the biggest thing to touch on is that the insecurities and the fear and the doubt, that will never be completely gone.
Yeah.
You know, that will always be there, but it's what you do with it. You know, it's how you move past it and you
yeah,
do it
your
anyway.
Purpose of why you're doing it is what fuels you, what really drives you. Just like, you know, because she knew that all those haters and all those people were against what she wanted. She was like, no, it is the right thing to do.
Yep. Like, she knew.
She
I would love to know what your why was, Emma. Like, what was your why? How'd you get through that? All right, what else did she say in her speech? Because we were talking about something earlier that was really cool that she said.
Yeah, she had made this point that if men can be accepted in the community without being aggressive, like what men should be like, then it should be okay for women to not be submissive and to also be accepted. So she was basically saying, like, let women be who they want to be. If they want to shave their armpits, let them shave their armpits, but don't judge them for it. Or, you know, just like, if they want to build strong muscles and be CEOs and be, like, you know, the top of their game, like, that's okay for them to be strong and powerful.
Yeah.
And it's okay to not, too. Just give women the choice to be that without judging them.
I love that. And, you know, I think it really depends on where you live, too. It obviously makes a big difference of what you might be going through as a woman, you know, what things you might be facing. You know, some people watching this in different areas might be like, oh, well, I feel like I have the choice. But some people might not. I think really joining together as women to support each other and encourage each other and inspire each other, that knowing that, like, when we all stick together, that's when we all win. And that, you know, she's doing that, and that's why we're big fans. Thank you, Emma, for everything that you do.
Yes.
Not only in your craft and your art to inspire the world with your films, but also using your platform for so much good.
Yes. And so we celebrate you.
We celebrate.
Women world changers. Anyways, it was super fun having you guys with us today.
So fun.
Again, I'm Nikki Soohoo.
Rachele Brooke Smith. And stay tuned for the next episode. And please comment, like, share, subscribe. We want to know who you want us to do next.
Yes.